الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربنا زدنا علما. So we are going to start our first session of this week, and as we know that we were on the Nahav part. And the most important part of the grammar that was we started fragments, and the fragments that there are the five fragments: mudaf, mudaf ilay, sifa, masuf, jar, majroor, and nawasibul ism. And then ismul ishara, mushar ilay. So we have covered so far mudaf, mudaf ilay, sifa, masuf. Today we will do the jar, majroor. Just to recap, we started this Nahav with properties of ism. Brother Ahsan, just properties of ism, if you can just recall the properties of ism. How many properties of ism, and name them, please?
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
So there are four properties of ism.
Yes.
We start with the type.
If you just go by in order, number.
Okay. Let's go by in yeah. order. So it's number.
Yes. Second.
Second is the gender.
Gender. Yes.
The type is qism, and last one is i'rab, status.
Status. So number, gender, type, and status. Number, gender, type, and status. Okay. So I would go to Safi. Just a small question from Safi, and everybody have to just, I say kuffar. Okay, Safi, you are there?
Yes.
I say kuffar. Just tell me that, is it muzakkar or muannas? Masculine or feminine? Kuffar.
Kuffar.
Everybody can think over it. I just said the question is kuffar. Is it masculine or feminine? First, tell me, Safi, this is just a revision. Is it singular or plural?
It's plural.
Plural. If we say it is plural, there are two types of plural: solid plural or broken plural. So is it kuffar is solid plural or broken plural?
It's a broken plural.
Broken plural. Why it is broken plural?
It's not following the same.
Follow pattern. The same normal pattern like kafirun. It is kuffar. And then tell me, if it is broken plural, is it masculine or feminine?
It's feminine then.
Feminine. Why?
Because it's a broken plural.
All broken plural treated as third person, singular, feminine. Okay, so this is very much just with one question. We just to recap the things that kuffar, the question was, is it masculine or feminine? So we started with singular, plural, broken plural, or solid plural, and we reached to the answer that it is feminine. Okay, so we have to go for the fragments. We did mudaf, mudaf ilay. I would go to Brother Ahmed. Brother Ahmed, you are there? Okay. I should go to start with Farhan Bhai. Farhan Bhai, conditions for mudaf. How many conditions? Just to recall us so that we should remember those things.
So, mudaf has got two conditions.
Yes.
So, one. Number one, there is no al with the mudaf.
Yeah, this is the second condition. There will be no al.
No al. Right.
Mudaf does not take al. And the al, first condition right. is Farangi.
And first condition is that mudaf will always be light.
Right? Always light. So when we say it is always light, what does it mean?
It means that it doesn't have a tanween or there is no noon sound.
Ending noon sound. Thank you very much, Farangi, for recalling us. This is mudaf. I have two conditions. One, that it should be light, and second is that it does not like al. Mudaf ilay. I would ask to Brother Hamid. One condition for mudaf ilay.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
It's always majroor.
It's always majrur. And one more thing, brother Hamid, mudaf mudaf ilay is combination of two verbs are two nouns. That's it. Thank you. So we have to go for the revision for the second thing, and that is sifa mausuf. Brother Rida.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Brother Rida, what about sifa mausuf? It is combination of
Two nouns.
Nouns. And what is the important thing for the sifa mausuf?
The first one is mausuf. The second ism is sifat. And all these all properties of mausuf is taken by sifat.
Okay, that's
Sifa follows all four properties of mausuf.
All four properties of ism should match in case of sifa mausuf. Four properties, same. They should be same.
And for instance, gents, number, gender, and status, and
type. Marfu. Thank you very much, brother.
You're welcome.
So this is just a thing that, and one thing that all the attached pronoun, kitabuhu, kitabuhum, baituhu, baituhum, they are also mudaf, mudafilay. And we discuss this all, and also there will be multiple mudaf, and one can be in the middle, can be mudaf, mudafilay for the second. And there are special mudaf like ba'dukum, ba'da, hatta, ghaira. So these are the special mudaf. And there are asma'ul khamsa, we just see that akhi, akhu, akha, akhi. Akhi is the majroor. Abu, abi is the majroor. Zu, za, zi. And sifa masuf, all four properties should match. And we did it. Today we are going to start the third fragment, that is jar majroor. First is jar. Jar is very important. That jar is, they are haruf jar. We discussed little bit in the level zero. Some haruf jar, there are many. Most commonly used, I think there are 11 haruf jar. They are called haruf jar. Jar. Like the most commonly used, min, fi, bi, ila, ala, fee like this, and there are many ka, and you will see that va also. So these are haruf jar like min. Tanjeen is there.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum. Tanjeen, min means
mean.
Min. Min kasra noon min.
From.
So this is also haruf jar. Can you please make that complete table for min? Min who? Attach it.
Min who? From
min
him,
who, min hum.
Min hum, from them, min.
Yes.
Min ta.
Min ka.
Min ka.
From min, you.
From you. Min kum, from you all. Min ni, from me. Min yes. Na, from us. From us.
Just revise in Arabic again, in order. Min hu.
Min hu, min hum, min ka, min kum, min ni, min na.
Min na, thank you. Burak. I think Burak is
my. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Burak. B means ba kasra b.
With.
Can you please attach it? Bihi.
Bihi. Bihum. Bika.
Bihim.
Bihu. Bihim. Bika.
Bihi. 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 Bihim. This is level zero.
Bihi. Bihum.
Bihim.
Bihi. Bihim. Bika. Bikum. Bi. Buna.
Bina. Yeah. Bina. This is level zero. Long time you are with us. Please. This is the first. Many time. Bihi. Bihim. Bika. Bikum. Bi. Bina. With translation.
Bihi. With him.
Yes.
Pika,
bihim,
bihim, bihim, with them. Pika, with you.
Okay. Musab. Musab Iqbal.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Can you please complete bihi, bihim?
Okay. Bihi, with him. Bihim, with them. Bika, with you. Bikum, with you all, be with me, bina with us.
With us. Thank you. Jafar Iqbal.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum. Jafar Iqbal, there is ala. Ala is also haruf jar. Can you please just join it? Alayhi.
Alayhi, alayhim, alayka, alaykum, alayna.
Alayya, alayna.
Alayya, alayna.
With translation, alayhi.
Alayhi is upon him. Alayhim is upon them. Alayka is upon you. Alaykum, upon you all. Alayyi.
Alayya.
Alayya. Upon
me.
I.
Yes, upon me. Yes, good.
Alayna, upon us.
Yes, very nice. So these are some of Harufi Jar we covered in Jar in level zero. So there are many. Like there is a list of that. We should first know the meaning of those. And then we will see that these all you list, see the in the first column, the list of that. These all are Harufi Jar. And most commonly used in almost in every line of Quran. We say them in English, they are prepositions. And the meanings is very important. Second thing, in level zero, we attach them like li. It can be lahu, lahum, laka, lakum, li, lana. Li means far. And all are. First thing, we should know the meaning. These are called harufi jar. We are discussing about jar majrur. So whenever whenever they come before any noun, whenever they come before any noun, they make that noun as majrur. This is the important thing. So what they do, they make the noun, whatever come after them, that will become majrur. So just to recap, there are three status, as we know that ism has three status. That is marfu, mansub, and majrur. In singular case, you know that muslimun, musliman, muslimin. Dual case, mani, muslimani, muslimaini, muslimaini. In plural case, muslimuna, muslimina, and muslimina. And there are some exception. We did it and with the light and heavy. So jar majrur, what is? Mudaf mudaf ilay, that is combination of two noun. Sifa masuf, that is combination of two noun. Their jar, normally these, we say they are letters, haruf, harufi jar. And second thing is whatever that is noun. So jar majrur, what they do, whenever these jar, harufi jar comes before the noun, they make the noun majrur. This is the only thing. So harufi jar, after the harufi jar, whatever come, that will come become majrur. Like lillahi, li is harufi jar. Allah is noun. So lillahi, that's why it is kasra, because Allah will be majrur because of harufi jar. Bismillahi, ismi, there are two words, bi, this is harufi jar. Why it is not ismu? Why it is not isma? Why it is ismi? Because of this b. Because harufi jar, what they do, they make the noun after them as majrur. And it affects them. And we discussed this many times, also in the second session, especially when we apply these rules. They can affect more than one word if they are separated by a vowel. So there are many, like b means with, ta, this is... Asmiya, this is for just for Allah. This is used in swear by. Ka, like. Ka, mithli. Ka, athfi. Li. Va. La, vau, qasmiya. Normally, vau, that is, we know that is just for conjunction. But this is our vau, qasmiya. Wallahi. Whenever it comes, you will say that the ism will be majrur. Not asra, asri. Why? Because this waw is waw qasmiya and this is haruf e jar. And what it does, it make the ism majrur. Wal qamari, wal qalami. So these are the important things. Fi qulubihim, fi qulubi. Why it is not quluba? So this is because of fi. Fi is haruf e jar. Okay. Next thing is, let's say we see the hadith. I say an Aisha. An Aisha, brother Naeem. If I say It is from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. So what will be an Aisha tu, an Aisha tar, an Aisha ti?
An Aisha tu.
Okay, let's.
Because it's Aisha.
An is what?
An is harf jar.
Jar. What does jar do?
Oh yeah, majroor.
So it make the noun majroor. Let's go but to the noun. The noun is Aisha. So my question is, will it will be Aisha tu, Aisha ta, or Aisha ti?
I think this is because Aisha is partially flexible too, right?
Name just is... first answer the question, Naeem bhai. It will be Aisha tu, Aisha ta, or Aisha ti.
An Aisha tu.
An, what an do?
Make
is make majroor. Okay, make majroor. Now let's go to Aisha and see that what is the form for majroor form of Aisha. As you said, it is a Aishata. Feminine names.
An Aishata.
Aishata. Feminine name. You see that they are as you said. You remind me that it is partially flexible. It is Aishatu, Aishata, Aishata. Their masoor and majroor is same. So it will be an Aishata.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Nimbay. Just to recall, we have to recall them again and again.
Okay.
We will just apply them. Jazakallah khair. Okay. Similarly here, ila yawmil qiyamati. So this yawmi, so ila also affects, ila is towards, also affect the yawm. So whenever it comes before noun, when there will be a jar, so what it does, it will make it majroor. Okay. I have one question. Let's talk about question. And questions are very important. So I will take, this is for understanding. I think Brother Ijaz will help me in this. Brother Ijaz.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Brother Ijaz, if I say, lil muslimuna, any mistake in this?
Yes. Li, a Muslim. Muna is marfu status, and because of li, we should say muslimina.
Muslimina, very nice. So li is what?
It's harfe jar.
Harfe jar. What does harfe jar does?
It makes the noun that comes after it majroor.
Majroor. And as you said, I said lil muslimuna, and you said it is wrong because li is harfe jar, and li makes noun majroor. And what is the majroor form of muslimun? That is Muslimin. Thank you. Is there Ibrahim Farhan?
Yes.
Ibrahim. Ibrahim, see here. Lil kafirina. Can you please explain why it is not kafiruna? Why it is kafirina?
Because of the li.
Li is what?
A fragment.
Li is what?
A fragment?
No. Li is what?
Majroor. Oh, majroor. Majroor.
Li is what?
Majroor.
No. Okay, Ibrahim, I know that you were not focused. I will just now listen to the answer from the brother Iqbal Shahid. Okay, please focus. We just need our kids that they should be focused, please. Okay, brother Iqbal, can you please explain?
Assalamu
alaikum.
So, Li is... Rufajar.
Li is so Rufajar.
Yes. Okay. So whatever will follow, if it is followed by a noun, it has to be majroor status.
It has to be majroor status. So kafirun is what?
So kafirun is not possible because kafirun is marfu status.
Okay. Brother Reza, so please may I mute the mic, please. Brother Reza.
Should I mute the mic?
No, I asked the brother. Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. So kafirun is possible
because kafirun is marfu status. It has to be majroor status. So what is the majroor status of kafirun? It is kafirin. So that is why li should be followed. If li is followed by a noun, it has to be kafirin. And kafirun is not
Thank
possible.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for nice. Ibrahim, these are harufi jar. All this is the list of harufi jar. Meanings are there. Whenever harufi jar comes after noun, after that harufi jar will be majroor. Okay, Ibrahim.
Yes.
Thank you. I would go to someone. Just there is a sawal Ashar bhai, brother Ashar.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam. Brother Rashid, this is min akhihi. Everybody please see here. Min akhihi. Akhi is, we see that there are three forms of akhi. What are those?
Akhi is akhi, akha, and akhu.
So in order, if we say first marfu is akhi.
First one, akhu is marfu. Akha is mansub and akhi is majrur.
Majrur. So why akha, akhu, akhu, akha, akhi. Akhu, akha, akhi. Akhi is majrur. So what is the, can you please explain min akhihi?
Okay, so min, because min is huruf jar, so that's why we have to use majrur form of akhu, and majrur form of akhu is akhi.
Akhi, akhu, akha, akhi. This is what we did say in five. There are zu, za, zi, and akhu. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So this is very important. Just we have to just remember, just again, properties of ism, there are four. We have each and every steps written on the slides. And second thing, we started with the fragments, mudaf mudaf ilay, sifa masuf, and today we discuss jar majrur. We just have to go for practice, for the practice session. I just request just to revise for 2 minutes the previous things, just to recall, and then we have to go for jar majrur. Over to breakout room.